Well, it's disturbing. It's very disturbing to hear the information we've received, and it's not been provided to the public, and what's happening as far as the samples, and it could and the different aspects of the chemical compounds that could cause cancer, and the exposure that we have, that even if you're not drinking it, by breathing it also could cause problems. And so this is something that we really need to keep a watch on. And one thing about it is that it's evident that we need to monitor everybody who's been exposed to this over a long period of time, because something like that doesn't necessarily develop quickly. It could be years before something like this would show up, particularly anything with cancer. And so the testimony today was quite disturbing, and I think the entire committee, a commission, the State Water Resource Commission, was kind of put back quite a bit, because that's not the information that we've been hearing as far as from the news media. So what he's testified today was the hard truth, and it definitely was very difficult. Well, I think evident from our speakers today that probably they don't know. And that's the thing. We're still, even the Marshall University and WVU and others are trying to figure this out. And so the U.S. Chemical Board and other groups are still trying to figure out what we have. But what concerns me is the information they were giving out as if they did know. And that's also was brought up, that, you know, where they were saying, go ahead and drink it. It's okay, safe now. Well, we've heard from both on Friday from the U.S. Chemical Board that it wasn't, and now today with Dr. Simonton that it's not safe to drink. And matter of fact, it might not even be safe to breathe in regards to this, because he had found formaldehyde samples at the Vandalia Grill downtown Charleston, and it could be other places. And so this is a compound, that a chemical that causes cancer. And so to me, I think that's where the disappointment is that these authorities are saying things without having proper science backing up. They do not know, but they're going ahead and saying it anyhow, and we're still uncertain about that, even exposing people even more and also elevating the risk of people's health even more by doing this. So we really have to get a handle on this and really truly tell the people the truth about what's going on with them. It's their lives, and we need to tell them the truth. I would say it's also step one. We need to do it simultaneously. We need to be moving forward. I mean, the whole idea of Senate Bill 373 is to make sure it doesn't happen again anywhere in West Virginia. Now we have to look at what do we do in response to now it's happened. And this is an ongoing situation that's unraveling as we get more and more information. And how do we help those individuals, that those people that have been exposed to it, which is all of us here in Charleston and Kanawha Valley, in some manner. Even if you're not using the water directly, you still could be breathing it. It could be in the air because of the fact of the vapors, as was testified today. So we all been exposed to this. And what does that mean? What does that mean to our lives? And what can we do to respond to that and help with our health concerns? I mean, you know, this is something that the medical community is going to have to respond, because if people start getting sick with it, how do we treat those individuals? How do we help them? And these are things that's going to be long term, but we need to get answers quickly, because people are afraid and they need answers. They want to know the truth about this situation and their lives and the way it's impacting them and their families.